Welcome to another episode of Teradata Tech Bytes. My name is Tim Miller, and I'm on the Advanced Analytics Product Management team at Teradata. This is the final part of a four-part series on Analytics Library. In this episode, I'll show you how you can use the Analytics Library to do predictive modeling and scoring. Now let's get into the final step, which is some modeling. So for the analyses that we've seen thus far, one or more queries are put together and optimize as a single query to the database. In the case of the algorithms, though, they're iterative, right? And that's where you can't do in pure SQL, and that's where the power of the external sort procedure comes into play. So in this case, for these algorithms, the external sort procedure actually acts as the iterator, and it dynamically generates SQL, sends it down to the AMPs, and then it receives the result sets back, and it makes the determination, have I converged to a solution, or do I need to iterate once more? So let's take a look at logistic regression, which will be used to build the model that will specify the propensities of our customer base to open up a credit card account or no. And there's a bunch of options. I'm not going to go through all of them, but you see some options for stepwise, which are backward, backward only, forward, forward only. You can exclude columns if you use all options. You can specify condition index threshold. You can specify the convergence criterion. You can specify an entrance criterion if you're using stepwise. There you see the forward only, backward only. There are group by columns you can specify. You can specify, I want lift input, maximum number of iterations, et cetera, et cetera. So we're not going to go into all those. They're all very well documented out on docs.teradata.com. Take a look if you're interested in all the nuances of logistic regression. What I will say about the algorithms is they return your result sets in tables that reside in the SQL engine. And those tables, in the case of logistic, have your coefficients and their associated statistical measures. They have the model statistics themselves. And then it has reports based on options that you select that are in XML format. And so that's kind of the reason we had to write a little bit of XML here. And this will go away in a future release, but for now, we just have to do a little parsing of the XML to make it look nice from a demo perspective. So let's take a look at how to call logistic regression. In this case, I'm going to just use all of the columns within my analytic data set, except I want to exclude state code. I'm going to do something different with that in a minute. And I want to exclude my credit card specific variables. The credit card account indicator is the one that I'm going to use as my dependent variable or my response variable. I'm going to generate a near dependency report and a multi-threshold report using this condition index threshold and this variance proportion threshold as well. And you can see the first object returned in my model are my coefficients, right? So here's all of the variables that made it into the model. I get my coefficient value itself, also a standardized version of it. I get standard error. I get a wall T statistic. I get a p-value, an odds ratio, and a lower and an upper bound as well. The second thing that I get is my model statistics. So what are my total observations? What's my initial and final log likelihood, likelihood ratio, test G statistics, chi-square degree of freedom, etc. Then within the XML itself is the multi-threshold success table. Basically, I'm getting as a count of my responders and my non-responders for each iteration, including those that are false negative and false positive as well. So that's the first model I'm going to build, and we'll go ahead and evaluate and score it in a minute. But I want to show you the power of this group by next. So in this case now, I want to group by my state code, which means I got to pull out all of my state indicator variables as well as my credit card specific variables. I'm leaving all of those arguments basically the same. So what do I get now? So for my coefficient table, for every state code and every column that made it into that model for that state code, I'm getting the B coefficients and the standardized coefficients and my standard error, etc. And then for my statistical measures table, I've just generated seven different models, one for each state code, and then all the other ones that I lumped into this other category. And you see here, Ohio didn't build right. It basically got a singular matrix because there was not enough data for that particular state. And then again, for the multi-threshold success table, for every iteration, it's showing you the responders, the non-responders, and then those false negative, false positive. So now let's evaluate each one of those models. So one of the differences between the SQL implementation and the Python implementation is that when you build the model, you can evaluate it simultaneously. We made those separate steps within Python. Again, a bunch of options for you, and then some XML parsing that we're going to be making much easier in the future. But the idea here, and we can only evaluate where we did not use the group by options. So in the case where we built all of the state code models, currently those cannot be evaluated. But you can do some of the same metrics when you go ahead and build the model. So I'm passing in that logit model, the very first one, the non-state code model, and I'm going to generate an output that has the customer ID and the probability column in it. Now, in this case, I'm going to generate three different types of output. So the first output I get is the lift table itself, which is cumulative in nature, and it is basically produced using the decile based on the probability values. Next is the multi-threshold success table, which once again is the for every iteration report that you get with your responders, your non-responders, and your false positive, false negatives. And then finally, the prediction success table is computed using only the probabilities and not the estimates. So now, final step, let's go ahead and score these models. And we'll go ahead and score that first one. And we're going to give it the actual value to put in addition to the probability. And you get basically your index of the analytic data set that you put together for the scoring, plus the actual and the estimate. And then in the case of the state code models, I'm basically adding to my customer ID the state code as well. And that concludes this demonstration. The last thing that you need to do is to remove your contacts and you are done. This concludes the TechBytes series on Vantage Analytics Library. If you're curious about using Python or R with Teradata Vantage, we have another TechBytes series focused on that subject. In that series, my colleague Alexander Kolovos and I discuss several options for using Python and R at scale with Vantage. Thank you again for watching the TechBytes series on Analytics Library, and have a nice day.